I recently created a prototype of my own Arduino-based phone. Time to improve it. In the previous video, I built a phone on a breadboard that I called CoolPhone. I had no major problems with the prototype, I just had to eliminate noises on the microphone and speaker. So it might seem that the rest of the project will go smoothly, and it should be, but it turned out a bit differently. After all, CoolPhone works, but let me tell you now that I have plans to make it better, but from the beginning. Based on the previously made prototype, I created a circuit diagram in Eagle. Like many of my previous projects, it consists of a microcontroller, a charging and programming module. I created filters for the microphone and speaker using the GSM module catalog node. Look on the symbol of this button. It can be concluded that its pin number 1 and 2 are connected, but it turned out they weren't. Another mistake was the wrong placement of the GSM module, because the gold pin connectors were blocking the removal of the SIM card. Unfortunately, I only noticed these errors when soldering the board. I decided to create another PCB. I corrected the previous mistakes, swapped the microcontroller cases, and moved all components to PCB design. First, I dimensioned the PCB, and then put all components in it. They had to be properly connected to form wires. With so many components, it would probably take me an hour or two, but I decided to try auto-routing for automatic wires creation. A few clicks, several seconds of waiting, and the project is ready. Of course, there were a few corrections to be made, but I saved a lot of time. Then I exported this design to Gerber files and ordered PCBs. I moved the PCB from Eagle to Fusion to see what it would look like and decided to make a housing for it right away. It consists of four parts: the main cover, the bottom cover, the top cover, and the keyboard. I wanted a unique keyboard and it turned out pretty well. After taking PCBs out of the box, I immediately started soldering, which I began by attaching the PCB to the substrate with tape. I put solder paste on the stencil and spread it over all the pads. I put SMD elements in their places and soldered them. As the next ones, I soldered the gold pin connectors and checked the communication with the microcontroller. Finally, I put the rest of the elements in their places and soldered them with a regular soldering iron. When everything was soldered, I wanted to make a test connection, but the diode on the module was blinking every second, which means that it can't connect to the network, and after sending AT comments to the module, I didn't get any answers. After a few hours of searching for errors, it turned out that the TX and RX wires from the GSM module were connected to the wrong pins of the microcontroller. The problem with connecting the module to the network disappeared when I connected the battery wires directly to the module. Once I had solved the electronics problem, it was time for the housing that I had already designed, so I just had to print it. I painted the printed parts with sprays in various colors according to the previous design and left them to dry for about 2 hours. The only thing left to do is assemble the whole thing and tighten the screws. The coolphone is ready. As I said before, I plan to improve a few more components in this project, mainly in the software, but also in the appearance of this device. I would like its dimensions to be as small as possible.
Hello, it's me. Hello, it's Santos Goodbye.